stop playing with him, big ho.
Oh, my boy,
focus.
Hey,
big ho, you on the
man's
side, man.
Big ho, fam.
Now, this is what happens. I went up to the doctor's the other day to check myself out. And I have two clots in my leg. One in my right leg, one in my left leg, which is my thighs. Okay, so now I'm having a procedure tomorrow to try to get those clots so now I could have proper blood flow through the leg so they can fix the toes. Okay, that's what's going on. That is it. You heard it from me. That's what's going on. I appreciate you. I appreciate your gestures. I appreciate your prayers. And I'm receiving all kind of emails and everybody, not just from me, from my friends, family members, everybody. And let me tell you about the funniest one. It's a guy emailed one of my friends that said that they have the remedy, because all y'all have remedies now. I don't know where you've been to for the last 2 years, but everybody got a quick fix solution now. They said they have the remedy that all my toes will grow back. They said, my toes. You already know who it was. You already knew it was, but let me make sure I got everything. So now I can finally move forward and get this stuff fixed. So I'm having surgery tomorrow. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for your love. Thank you for support. And you got to understand, I ain't going nowhere. Because we coming. I ain't going nowhere. I'm just trying to get all this straight. So when I walk that sideline and I walk my walk, because I'm going to talk my talk, that I can walk my walk. All right? God bless y'all. I appreciate you. I truly do.
The vaccines unequivocally cause blood clots through the mechanism of producing the Wuhan spike protein. The spike protein, which is now in the bodies of everyone who've taken these vaccines, promotes blood clots, large blood clots. A paper from the FDA by Wu and colleagues from the U.S. FDA published in the peer-reviewed literature described thousands of blood clots that they had in a sample going from the ankle to the hip, the largest blood clots we've ever seen, shooting to the lungs. 11% of cases in the Wu paper were fatal. My experience with these blood clots are they're enormously resistant to blood thinners. We're using all different types of blood thinners, adding additional drugs, and they are not going away like characteristic blood clots. Studies show the Wuhan spike protein is inside the blood clots, and it's folding, forming what's called amyloid structures. Amyloid structures are like rubber in the human body. They look like rubber, and the blood clots are large and rubberized, and they are not being dissolved. A very disturbing paper recently published by Lee and colleagues with a sample of millions and millions of patients from 2021. They had unvaccinated and vaccinated. They did careful retinal scans. This is astonishing. They found astronomical rates of blood clots in the retinal arteries and retinal veins in those vaccinated compared to the unvaccinated. And that was only with two shots back in 2021. 2 years later, these still exist. They're still there. The risk is there. So what I'm telling you is these vaccines have a very long effect in the human body. And when we see blood clots in the arteries, small arteries and veins of the eyes, they're reflecting what's going on in the body. The blood clots are coming from elsewhere. And so they certainly can be a cause of blindness, but is a general reflection of blood clotting occurring through the body throughout. This is a very large study, and the longest study showing that there is a tail, at least a 2-year tail, of risk and concern of anyone who's taken one of these vaccines back in 2021.